Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Faith City's online service today on this special Sunday, Resurrection Sunday. We thank God for your life. We thank God that we are alive. We thank God that we woke up in the land of the living, in a time and a season where everybody seemed to be burying their loved ones. We thank God that we made it to another day. I just want to encourage your hearts, especially those who has lost loved ones recently. The Bible says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. I want you to understand that God is not scratching his head trying to figure this thing out. I want you to know that God has already worked this thing out, and we're going to come out of this in Jesus' name. I just want us to take courage. I want us to really begin to go on our knees and go before God and really seek the face of God, especially concerning the next step of our lives. Amen. I really believe that our lives will never be the same after this, but I believe that God has a master plan.
great you are.
How great you are.
How great, how great.
Today's scripture is from Luke chapter 24, verses 1 to 12. Now on the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they and certain other women with them came to the tomb, bringing the spices which they had prepared. But they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. Then they went in and did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. And it happened, as they were greatly perplexed about this, that behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. Then, as they were afraid and bowed their faces to the earth, they said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but he is risen. Remember how he spoke to you when he was still in Galilee, saying, 'The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and the third day rise again.'" And they remembered his words. Then they returned from the tomb and told all these things to the 11 and to all the rest. It was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary, the mother of James, and the other women with them who told these things to the apostles. And their words seemed to them like idle tales, and they did not believe them. But Peter arose and ran to the tomb, and stooping down, he saw the linen cloths lying by themselves, and he departed, marveling to himself at what had happened.
Stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross, his blood poured out for us. The weight of every curse upon him. The power of hell forever broke.
I want to remind you that prayer still works. I know sometimes people have given up on prayer and said, what's the use of praying? You know, I prayed, you know, and nothing happened. I prayed and my mum died, my dad died, my brother died. You know, prayer still works. I want you to understand something, that God is sovereign and God knows everything from the beginning. He is Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Sometimes we don't fully understand, you know, what God is up to and why certain things happen the way it did. I remember when my father passed away in 2016 and I dared to question God, and I said to God, couldn't you have made him live for a few more years so that I can spend time with him, so the family could be with him? But it was God's timing for his life. And sometimes we question God, not knowing that God has a plan. Today, I want us to remember our young people. Many times we're not hearing the stories that are being reported because the media is not reporting them. But I want you to know that our young people in the inner cities still need our prayers. They still need our love. They still need our support. I want you to pray for those that are caught up in gang violence, those that are caught up with drug dealing, those that are caught up with being in care, those that are feeling suicidal, those that are dealing with mental illness. Our young people still need the prayers of the church. I just want to leave this scripture with you, this word of encouragement. It says in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 13, when I shut up heaven and there is no rain, or command the locust to devour the land, or send pestilence among my people, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you right now that we are covered by your presence, even in this dire situation that our world is facing. We know that you are still talking and moving. We walk by faith and not by sight. We will not operate in the spirit of fear, but in love. You said in your word, you will keep us in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you. We declare faith over fear. We declare a sound mind. We declare courage and wisdom. We declare God's provision and protection. We declare God's will to be done in the earth. May God bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. May he direct your path and order your steps. The word of the Lord says, you shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. God bless you, and thank you for joining us today.